In this circuit, we have to find the equivalent capacitance between P and Q. Now at first, it may look like to be in series, but actually they are not in series. Why? Because in series connection, it would have been like this. See, when they are in series, there is nothing connected in between. But in this case, between C1 and C2, there is a connection, something is connected here. Similarly, between C2 and C3, something is connected here. So these three are not in series. So this is not equivalent to this. This is the first thing. So they don't look like to be in parallel connection. When you look at it, they do not look like to be in parallel connection. So let's watch it closely. See, this plate of C1 is connected to this plate of C2. So this is connected to this. Now follow this part. This goes here, goes here, goes here. So this plate of C3 is connected. That means this plate, and this plate. These three are connected. Now look here. This plate of C2 is connected to this plate of C3. Now follow this part here. So that means this plate of C1 is connected. So this plate of C1, this plate of C2, and this plate of C3 are connected. So to what we get here is, the circuit is something like this. Say if it is C1, this is C2, this is C3, so one plate of each capacitor is connected and other plate of the capacitors are connected. So this is point P, this is point Q. Once you realize this, you can easily see that this is a parallel connection. So therefore, the equivalent capacitance is simply C1 plus C2 plus C3. So in questions like this, we have to use our brain to see whether they are in parallel or they are in series or they are in some other connection.